Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. This week you are going to be studying the main idea.
You put your right foot in, you put your right foot up, you put your right foot in and you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. Left foot.
So this week we're doing main idea, and we're going to throw some descriptive text in there while we're at it. So here's what you need to know about descriptive text. First, it is always going to be a paragraph or a passage that tells what something looks like or what something acts like. And here are some signal words to help you figure out that it's descriptive text. Looks like, characteristics, for example, for instance, most important, such as, and consists of. So don't worry about remembering all of these, because you will get a bookmark on Monday that has these there that you'll be able to keep for reference. So when you have a descriptive text, what do you do with it? You code it. These steps will look familiar to you. We just have one more that we've added in. So the first step, as always, is to circle our topic. The second step is boxing the signal words, which we haven't done in a while, so this will be a refresher. And then double underline the main idea. We'll get to that in a minute. And last, underline important facts. We can't underline events, because in a descriptive text, there's not events, there's just facts, what it looks like or how it acts. So here we go. We have a paragraph here. While I read, think about what the topic is going to be. What word do you see over and over and over? Mammals need to have healthy hearts. For example, the elephant's heart beats very slowly because it is a large mammal. Already seen mammal twice. That might be the topic. The hummingbird's heart consists of many beats per minute because this mammal is small. There it is again. Mammals' heart rates, again, depend on their size. The bigger the mammal, the slower the heartbeat. I'm ready to say that mammal is going to be the topic. The giraffe breaks the rule, though. The long-necked mammal's heart has to beat very quickly so the blood can get up to its head. So that is the topic, mammals. And while I read, I noticed that I saw two signal words. I saw for example and consists of. So they get a box. Now let's talk about finding the main idea. First thing we do is find the narrow topic. The topic by itself is not enough when we look for the main idea. We have to figure out what specifically is it telling us about the topic. So our topic was mammals, but what is it about them? Is it about what they eat or where they live or what they look like? Not really. It's about their heartbeats. So the narrow topic is mammals' heartbeats. Now that we know this, we can move to the next step. Comparing each sentence to the other sentences in a paragraph. We have to be able to combine and connect sentences to each other so that we can know which one is the topic sentence. And that main idea, that topic sentence, is the one sentence that connects to all or almost all of the other sentences. Sometimes you'll get a sentence in there that doesn't really go with anything else, and we'll talk about that in a minute. For now, let's go back to our paragraph about the mammals. So we're going to take this sentence by sentence, starting with the first one. Mammals need to have healthy hearts. Now I know that the narrow topic is about heartbeats. Healthy hearts and a heartbeat, those are different things. So this doesn't even go with our narrow topic, so there's no way that that one is the main idea. So let's look at the next one. For example, the elephant's heart beats very slowly because it is a large mammal. Well, we've got heartbeats in there, so it's better than the first sentence, and it's about an elephant. So I'm going to think, are there any other sentences in there about elephants? There's one about hummingbirds and a couple about giraffes and one about mammals in general, so no. That's the only sentence about an elephant, so that can't be the main idea either. So let's look at the others. The hummingbird has its own sentence, but that's the only sentence about the hummingbird. Then we get to this one. Mammals' heart rates depend on their size. The bigger the mammal, the slower the heartbeat. So this is about all mammals and how big they are and how slow or fast their heartbeat. So this one does connect to the elephant because an elephant is a mammal. It also connects to the hummingbird because the hummingbird's a mammal. And both of those two sentences talk about heartbeats too. So this one might be the main idea. Let's see if it connects to the other two. The giraffe breaks the rule though. On the surface, that doesn't look like that. This mammal sentence connects to the giraffe, but a giraffe is a mammal. And what rule is it breaking? It's breaking the heartbeat rule. So it does connect back to this sentence here. And the last sentence, the long-necked mammal's heart has to beat very quickly so the blood can get up to its head. That one relates back to this sentence about all mammals too. So the main idea is this one. It's the only one that has to do with almost all of the other sentences. So now that we found the main idea, we can underline the important facts. And I see three different types of animals in here, mammals. And each of them is important because they're treated equally, so I'm going to underline the part about the elephant, the part about the hummingbird, and the part about the giraffe as my important facts. But what about irrelevant details? These are the sentences that do not go to the main idea. They're just kind of thrown in there. Sometimes they sound really out of place. Sometimes they kind of do go, but they're still not important. When we find them, we're going to leave them alone now. We used to cross them out. We're just going to leave them now. We're not even going to consider them or mark them in any way because they're not important. And when we do a graphic organizer like a bubble map or a chart or a flow map, those irrelevant details will not go in there because they do not belong. So back to our paragraph. Got the main idea here. The whole paragraph is talking to us about mammals' heartbeats and how big they are and how slow or fast the heartbeat is. So then we have the section about the elephant, the hummingbird, and the giraffe. And since I underlined stuff there, I know that those sentences are relevant. We need them. But there is one that is irrelevant. It doesn't have anything to do with a heartbeat. Healthy hearts and heartbeats, two different things. So we are not going to need that one at all. It does not belong. So when we go to our reformatting, we're going to leave that one out. When you reformat descriptive text, it's always a bubble map. So here we go. We've got a bubble map here, and in the middle goes the narrow topic, which was mammal heartbeats. And everything we underlined in any way, shape, or form goes in the bubble. So we underlined parts about the elephant's heartbeat and the hummingbird's heartbeat, as well as the giraffe's heartbeat, and then we also underlined, it was a double underline, but still an underline, the main idea. The bigger the mammal, the slower the heartbeat. So we've reduced that paragraph to its most important facts. And now we can use that to base our understanding off of everything and make sure we learned what the paragraph wanted us to learn. So that's all there is to main idea and descriptive text. Don't forget the transmorgification challenge. There will be a new one on the next slide that you'll see, so don't leave yet. And if you get your dictionary out and you find the meanings for all of the words and you think you know what nursery rhyme it is this time, post it in class chatter. So here you go.
Bags full, one for my master and one for my dame, and one for the little boy who lives down the lane. Baa, baa, black sheep, have you any wool?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Three bags worth. Sing a song of sixpence, a pocket full of rye. 4 and 20 blackbirds baked in a pie. When the pie was open, the birds began to sing. And wasn't that a dandy dish to set before the king?